Underneath the ocean surface situates an enormous amount of valuable metal, such as gold, silver, copper, manganese, cobalt, and zinc. A method called deep sea mining, or seabed mining, is proposed to exploit these materials, promising to supply the world's growing demand for these precious elements. So how does deep sea mining work, and what controversy lies in it? Currently, all the mining operations are extracting materials at a maximum depth of around 200 meters. The majority of deep sea mining sites, on the other hand, are at 1400 to 3700 meters, but some can be as deep as 6 kilometers. First, remotely maneuvering vehicles are sent to analyze a potential mining location. Once the site has been detected, ships or stations would be set up in the area. There are two types of extractions being considered for operation: hydraulic suction systems and continuous line bucket systems. The hydraulic suction system works by lowering a specialized nodule collector attached to the ship through a vertical pipe. This machine is designed to withstand at least 600 times the pressure of the atmosphere on the surface and is able to pick up 400 tons of materials every single hour. Because most of the minerals are readily available near the surface of the ocean floor, once the vehicle reaches the mining site at around 5 kilometers, it uses water jets to remove the mud around the ores, making them free to be collected. This pipe also serves as a device to transport these ores back to the vessel. As it is so deep underwater, that high-pressure pumps need to be placed along the pipeline every kilometer. The materials pumped back to the ship contain minerals, but there are also unwanted water and sediments that were not removed. To store those nodules efficiently, we extract water and sediments from them, keeping only dry ores, and the separated plumes, including sediments, are returned to the ocean via a secondary pipe. The second approach is the continuous line bucket system, or CLB system. The system requires two ships linked by a long, closed line that covers the mining site. As the name suggests, the CLB system operates much like a conveyor belt of buckets. When the two ships pull the line in the same direction, the buckets start descending to the seabed, dragging the minerals along the path, and returning to the other ship, where they'll be processed and returned to the cycle. It is estimated that 20 million tons of gold, worth $770 trillion, are lying under the ocean surface. So why haven't we mined them yet? The answer is simple: cost and ecological damage. Similar to all mining activities, seabed mining raises concerns about possible impacts on the environment. Light, noise, and vibration during operations may disturb marine life in the surrounding area. The removal of a great area of the ocean floor can destroy the habitat of many animals, which might affect the food chain. Among the influences of deep sea mining, the discharge of sediment plumes is believed to have the most serious consequence. These plumes can travel a few thousand meters from the mining location, spreading over a vast area of water. Not only that, they may carry concentrations of metals that can be toxic to organisms, which can move through the food web to larger marine species, and eventually, humans. Since deep sea mining is a relatively new field, the total dangers of full-scale operations are yet to be completely understood. Despite various efforts to mine the ocean floor, at the present time, there is no commercial mining of seabed minerals. But it does not mean we abandon this technology. In fact, the opposite is true. Advancements in each operation phase, such as exploration, mining, transporting, storing, and offloading, as well as processing, have allowed us to lower the expense, bringing it closer to reality. If we can somehow find a way to be entirely environmentally friendly, one vision might be that deep ocean mining would provide a near-term solution to valuable metals that are in short supply, which are needed for wind farms, solar energy, electric cars, and battery technologies. After all, mining the deep sea is exploiting non-renewable resources, but we can use it as a source of material for green devices that can support a sustainable world.